Welcome to the National Black Health Agenda Forum. My name is Christina Epperson, and I am here with Reverend Anthony Evans, president of the National Black Church Initiative. Recently, his organization released a report to Congress entitled Addressing Social Drivers of Health, in which he asked for a $2.25 trillion increase in funding to go towards research and other efforts to eliminate health disparities in the Black community.
So the only factor that is going back to our drivers of health, the only factors is affordable health care, racism in health care, adequate health care, and of course, having economic development in our community. So let's solve this problem. But before we begin to solve this multi-year problem, we need in the Black community right now, in 2024, you don't have to wait until 2025. We know that the Congress is out right now and there's an election going on, but we'll wait until you get back. We need the Congress of the United States to authorize $2.25 trillion, and that what that would do, that will put the 20 million individuals who were on the COVID roads back on the roll of Medicaid and Medicare, so they would have access to care. So in other words, we would eliminate immediately through one act of Congress one of those drivers of health. Just eliminate that by putting those 20 million people back on pre-COVID levels, at 2020 levels, back on the rolls through Medicaid and Medicare, and then we can work on affordable housing. We can work on racism and in healthcare. We can work on economic programs that will stabilize the Black community so that we can have enough money to afford health insurance. So all of those folks that, but we need our country. This is our country who we're going to vote for in about 2 months. This is our country. We are asking, we are pleading that they authorize $2.25 trillion to, as a down payment of a good faith effort that they actually going to do something about health care. Up until this time, there has been over 250 reports on health disparities. That's all they have been, just words. Now what we are saying, we want you to turn those words into actions. And we're also saying that if you don't do it, do not expect for the Black church, which is 27.7 million, to show up at the polls to vote for you. So we are looking at what the Republicans put out. We are looking at what the Democrats has put out. We are looking at which party have done the most for African Americans, and we're voting accordingly. We're here to negotiate with either party. The Black church don't want to identify itself with the Republican Party. We don't want to identify ourselves with the Democratic Party. We want to identify ourselves with the party that cares about the Black community.